The Sekai Taikai is set to take place in Part 2 of Cobra Kai Season 6, which we will hopefully see in November this year. But how will the tournament actually work? So far, the only direct information we know about the tournament is in this very short clip.
This year's Sekai Taikai will be held in Barcelona, Spain.
We intend to test your dojo's quality, not quantity. And each dojo must select 6 fighters to compete. These 6 fighters will participate in team events, with one boy and one girl serving as captains to enter into the individual competitions, which will be televised around the world.
So pretty much, tournaments in Spain, 6 fighters per dojo, and each dojo will have one male and one female rep which will fight in the individual competition. But when you start to look into the details, it becomes much more unclear. At first I just thought the team competition will just be the skills competition similar to the All Valley tournament, and that the individual competition with the male and female captain will just be like a much bigger, higher level All Valley tournament with all the dojos from around the world. But when you listen closely to Gunther, you'll hear him say that the 6 selected fighters from each dojo will participate in team events, not singular team event or skills competition, which leads me to believe that there will be more than one type of team event competition. This wouldn't just be skills competition, but there might even be group fighting, but with different rules to individual tournament. So there could almost be a battle royale style fight, similar to what Mike Barnes did when he was trying to select who was going to be in the Sekai Taikai. But maybe instead of it just being every man for himself, it's on a team. So there'll be one dojo that say Cobra Kai versus some other random dojo, European dojo, whatever. And Cobra Kai will have yellow tags, the other team will have green tags. The yellow team will compete against the green team, and they'll each try to remove tags from each of the competitors. Once a competitor's tag is removed from that team, they're out, and then after maybe a minute or so of fighting, the team that has the most members remaining, or if within the minute all the members of one team are eliminated, the team that has the players still in will win. There might also be more than one skills competition, because in the All Valley tournament, some fighters use weapons and equipment, while other fighters just use their skill, their fighting technique. So there could be 2 separate skills competitions for those different things. There might also be things where the team captain has to lead the other members in some kind of almost team building style exercise, and the teams that win progress or get more points if they're doing a point style thing and a grand champion similar to the All Valley. I would absolutely love to see a team fighting situation where there's a tournament style fight but with 2 or 3 fighters rather than just one, and then they have to fight to a certain number of points, but supposing one fighter was being targeted by the opposing dojo, the other 2 fighters could defend them and then they could attack other members, and once a point is scored the fight is stopped and you just wait until one team has scored all the points. However, I don't know if this would be too complicated and too hard to keep track of, but it still would be really cool if they had something like that, because it would give us a chance to see characters like Hawk and Miguel still involved in fighting, just not individual fighting. But now to go into more detail about the individual competition, it says that the individual competition will be televised around the world, and it didn't say anything about the team events. So that to me suggests that only the individual competition will be on TV, and that's the only thing that the other students that didn't get to go will watch. But it'll probably have similar style rules to the All Valley tournament. There just might be some slight variations because of different countries competing in the tournament, and there might be a different number of points. There might be no time limit to sudden death. But on the whole, it's going to be, you hit this part of the body, you get a point, you get this many points, you win. Speaking of winning, if you guys want to know who I think will win the Sekai Taikai, then you'll want to watch the next video I'm going to have coming out, which is why I will predict who wins the Sekai Taikai. So make sure you subscribe if you want to watch that, because you don't want to miss it. But apart from that, that's pretty much all I have to say. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and let me know if you agree with me on how I think the tournament is going to go, or if you think, based on leaks or just based on your superior knowledge, that there will be differences that I haven't mentioned. I'd love to hear your feedback in the comments below. It's been your main Zach, and remember to stay amazing. Bye.